boys and girls. It's a nice, crisp fall morning. We've been talking about the leaves and the weather changing, and here we are. We're starting to see it. Today, I thought I would read something before I read my book. I like to read poetry sometimes. Poems are another way to use words and express feelings. Sometimes they have a lot of rhythm and rhyme, but not always. Sometimes they're silly, sometimes they're about the weather or whatever it could be. So today I brought one that's a fun one, and it has a lot of rhyme and rhythm in it. It's called Noise Day. Let's have one day for girls and boys when you could make the grandest noises. Screech, scream, holler, and yell, buzz a buzzer, clang a bell. Sneeze, hiccup, whistle, shout, laugh until your lungs wear out. Toot a whistle, kick a can, bang a spoon against a pan. Sing, yodel, bellow, hum. Blow a horn or beat a drum. Rattle a window, slam a door, scrape a rake across the floor. Use a drill, drive a nail, turn the hose on a garbage pail. Turn up the music all the way. Try and bounce your bowling ball, ride a skateboard up the wall. Chomp your food with a smack and a slurp, chew, chomp, hiccup, burp. One day a year do all of these, the rest of the days be quiet, please. That was a book from Falling Up by Shel Silverstein. There's a lot of books about poems, and you could even write a poem if you ever wanted to. Well, I brought a story today, and it's about an owl who loves poetry. Can you imagine? And in our story, he would love to recite poems and read books with poems, but the other owls just think that's really quite strange. So we're called the Otto the Owl Who Loved Poetry, and I brought my little owl from the backyard. I thought he'd enjoy the story along with us today. Let's try it out. The Otto the Owl Who Loved Poetry by, you know, we always like to say our author, Vern Kowski. Let's check this out. Otto is not like the other owls in the forest. You see, owls are supposed to roost in the hollow of a tree, but Otto would rather read books. There he is, up on the branch. Owls usually are alone, like Otto is. You know, we talk about a school of fish or a flock of birds. If you saw more than one owl together, it's called a parliament. That's very unusual, isn't it? The owls are supposed to hunt in the dark of the night, but Otto, he would rather make friends. Look at, he's making friends with a little mouse. The other owls are waiting to chomp down. Owls, of course, are not really supposed to recite poetry, but when the other owls are roosting or hunting, Otto finds a secret spot and he recites his favorite poems. Let us go then, you and I, when the evening is spread out against the sky. He loves those poems, doesn't he? One snowy night, Otto's secret is discovered. The cold wind burns my face and blows its frosty pepper up my nose. Oh, the other owls are noticing. They just like to hunt and roost. And look at, I don't think they're saying very nice things now about our little friend. Now, when the other owls see Otto, they laugh and shout, look, it's Blotto. Here comes Blotto the Bard. Oh, I see a sad face on our little friend Otto. Not nice at all. On his nightly walks, Otto sighs and sadly wonders, why do all the owls tease me? What could possibly be wrong with poetry? At last he decides to run away. Oh, look how sad he looks. As Otto wanders through the forest, the moonlight guides him. Well, dear moon, he says, I guess it's just you and me now. And he suddenly has an idea for a poem, the very first of his own creation. Oh, he's going to write a poem now. You could do that. You could make one up. Dear moon, you must be lonely so high up in the sky. I'm sure your heart's so heavy, sometimes you want to cry. But dear moon, please do not worry. I've a message here to send. I'm with you every evening. Dear moon, you're my best friend. Oh, there's a full moon up in the sky this night. He's looking right up at it, isn't he? Otto is surprised to see dozens of tiny faces looking up at him. He's even more surprised to hear dozens of tiny voices begin to shout, "More, more, more." Oh, the tiny mice were enjoying his poetry. Now he found someone who will appreciate it. So Otto delights the mice with another poem. "I think that I shall never see a poem as lovely as a tree that may in summer wear the nest of robins in her hair." Look at them all watching. Otto now knows that poetry should be shared with more than just the moon and the stars. Poetry should be shared with everyone. He's got quite an audience now, doesn't he, for his poetry? And so, when a few owls find Otto in the forest one spring night, he does not run and hide. Instead, he proudly recites, "I'm nobody. Who are you? Are you nobody too?" The more the owls listen, the less they feel like laughing. And when the poem is finished, they all hoot and holler, "More, more! Hoo, hoo, hoo." I think the owls are starting to like it now. This is great for Otto. The next night, another owl recites his favorite poem. "Who has seen the wind? Neither I nor you. But when the leaves hang trembling, the wind is passing through." And even a little mouse is inspired to write a poem of her own. "Oh, my beautiful hunk of cheese, you smell so sweet and good. Oh, my beautiful hunk of cheese, I'd marry you if I could." That was a silly poem, wasn't it? And so now, thanks to Otto, every night in the forest, life comes alive with the glorious sounds of poetry. So now, because he tried, and finally the other owls listened, they're all enjoying poetry. I hope you did too today with our little silly poem, and maybe you'll read some poems during the week. I love to read books. I love to read poetry. I love to read anything that I can get my hands on. So let's all read this week, and then I'll be back next week with another new story for you. Have a great week, boys and girls. Bye now.